Kate Hudson. Hi Abraham, great stuff. I have a really important question. What's your zodiac sign? It would mean so much if you replied. Kate Hudson, thank you for your comment. My zodiac sign is Gemini. I was born in May, but I'm not really a zodiac sign type of person. I don't know what that means. I know the sign is like two people, two like babies or two faces, but I have no idea what it means, Kate Hudson. So I'm a Gemini. If you watch this video, or if anyone else is watching, please tell me what my zodiac sign means. And if you can maybe tell me my future, please let me know too. If my future means that I hit 10 million subscribers, please let me know that too, because I feel like that will really make my day. Thank you for your comment. Hey everyone, you might have noticed this is a different setup to where we usually film, because I'm down in London at the moment doing some film work, but I thought to myself, whilst I'm here, why not film an episode of Responding to Your Comments? One of my favorite series to do, where we look at fun questions and health questions. So what are we waiting for? Let's do this. Shubham Jane, is being unable to completely empty my bladder a sign of a UTI? Shubham, thank you for your comment. Your name kind of reminds me of my name, Abraham, because it's got a ham in it, and Shubham. But yeah, this is from the UTI video that we did a while ago, all about urinary tract infections and why we get them and all about the anatomy and how many people get it and how you can prevent getting it as well. Now, is not being able to empty your bladder fully a sign of a UTI? Well, it's one of the symptoms of a UTI, but you know, it could be another a sign of something else as well. So you could have urinary retention, or if you're a man, you know, it might be a sign of an enlarged prostate, so you're not able to empty your bladder properly. So what I'm trying to get at is that it could be many different things, and just one comment with one piece of information on YouTube isn't enough for anyone, any healthcare professional, to make a diagnosis, which is why it's so important that if you ever have any symptoms that are out of the ordinary, that you speak to a healthcare professional so that they can have a consultation, so that they can examine you, so that it can send off for tests on you to make sure that they're diagnosing you properly. Now, in terms of urinary tract infections, which I'm going to call UTIs now for short because it's much easier to say and it's the proper medical abbreviation. So UTIs, they are the number one bacterial infection. They have 8 billion doctor visits per year just for UTIs. They affect women much more than men, and it's all due to the anatomy. So what are the symptoms of a UTI? Well, do you have urgency, which basically means, do you need to quickly go to the bathroom to pee? And also, do you have increased frequency? So have you got an increased frequency of needing to go to the bathroom and pee? And also, do you feel like you're not emptying your bladder fully, like there's something still left there? Now, you don't have to have all of these symptoms to have a UTI. You might have one of them, you might have all of them. And there are other symptoms as well. So for example, when you pee, you might have pain or a burning sensation. Your urine might be cloudy, it might be smelly, there might even be blood in it. You might feel tired, you might feel unwell. And if you're more elderly, you might notice that they're confused or more agitated. So those are probably some of the most common symptoms that I see in practice when someone has a UTI. But please remember, there are also many things that you can do to help prevent you from getting a UTI in the first place. And that's all explained in the video that we did previously, where I explained about clothing, toilet habits, cleaning hygiene, everything like that. So if you haven't seen that video, I will leave a link up here and in the description below for you as well. I'd highly recommend everyone to watch it. And also, another thing that I want to talk about is cranberry. Cranberry juice, cranberry supplements, cranberry tablets. Please remember, there's a lot of marketing going on out there that they help for UTIs, they help prevent a UTI, they help treat a UTI. But please remember, there is little slash no evidence supporting these claims that are being made. So please don't waste your money on it. And if you do have a UTI, always speak to your healthcare professional. Thank you for your comment. Fat Dog ASMR, you're my new daddy. Fat Dog ASMR, thank you for your comment. I wasn't aware that I'm a dad, but I will embrace it. This is from the sore throat video, how to get rid of it. I hope the tips were helpful. But funny that you should call me your new daddy, because I'm gonna tell you a funny story. So my surname is Khodadi, that's how you actually pronounce it. But you know, in the UK, everyone pronounces it Khodadi. Khodadi, so it's Abraham Khodadi. And in school, I always used to call the daddy, you know, Abraham the daddy. So yeah, it reminded me of that. It brought back some memories. But thank you for your comment. Helia Hamza, thank God you haven't prescribed paracetamol for this kind of thing. Helia, thank you for your comment. This is from the phone addiction video and social media addiction video, which we filmed in Turkey and Greece. It's a really great video. I will leave a link up here for you to watch it if you haven't seen it, all about how to reduce your phone usage and the actual effects of social media use in teenagers. So there's some really good research in that video that I talk about. but this one made me chuckle actually, paracetamol, because as a pharmacist, as a healthcare professional, you know, We love paracetamol. I talk about it all the time. And especially when I'm with my healthcare professional friends, we end up talking about health related stuff because generally speaking, that's what we do, unfortunately. And we have friends who aren't in healthcare, you know, and they get so sick of it that they always try and ruin our conversations by just talking about paracetamol. For some strange reason, they're like, yeah, paracetamol. Let's talk about something else. And I was like, all right, then let's move on. But yeah, it made me chuckle. Thank you for your comment. My dude, just watching and listening to you helped me feel better for almost 4 minutes. Thanks, bud. My dude, thank you for your comment. This is from the How to Get Rid of a Sore Throat video. Obviously, if you give Abraham the Pharmacist a compliment, he's gonna use it in a response to comments video. You know, your username also reminds me of Denzel Washington. I think it was an American gangster where he always used to say, my man. And that was a terrible American accent. I'm sorry to all the Americans out there who've just watched this terrible accent. But yeah, just remind me of that. But anyway, moving on to your comment. Thank you for it. And I'm glad it helped you. We've got some really useful tips in the sore throat video. So if you haven't watched it, I'll leave a link up here and in the description below for you, especially because right now it is winter and a lot more people are suffering from sore throats. But I'm glad that my energy, you know, and I helped entertain you as well whilst you learned a few things, because that's what I think is one of the unique aspects of my videos, that it's not just a healthcare professional sat down, like in responding to comments, giving you information, because health information can get a bit boring sometimes. So I do try and mix it up and give some energy back to you to hopefully make you feel better. And also, I think people learn better when they're having fun. So thank you for your comment. And it looks like we've run out of time again in this week's episode. If I didn't get back to your comment, if I didn't get back to your question, I'm really sorry. We are getting so many comments at the moment. It's very difficult to fit them all in one episode. So the best thing to do is leave another comment and I will try my best to get back to you in a future episode of responding to your comments. Always remember that you're awesome and I will see you next week. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's video. Make sure to click that like, follow, or subscribe button now to stay up to date with new weekly videos.